I just want to recap what we did in this lesson and remind you of the iterative process of sketching a visualization. We started with our bar chart. Notice that while it does some things well, such as highlight when games were not held, it doesn't really convey the trend in time that well, and also looks a bit strange since the bars are so thin, since they represent only 1 year. We then went to a scatter plot, which shows the trend a little bit better, as we can follow the circles as they rise and fall, captures the missing years in which a game was not held, but not nearly as well as the bar chart, but is typically used to represent things where the values on the x-axis aren't necessarily correlated or ordered. While the scatter plot has some of the benefits of the bar chart and some of the benefits of a line plot, it does a bit of a mediocre job at both. We then tried to iterate with a line plot, since it is most suited for time series data and conveys trends very well. Here we can easily see the trend in attendances over the history of the World Cup, but tends to obscure dates where there was no data or a game was not held. So to remedy this, we're going to add our scatter dots back in to show that because of World War II, there were no World Cup games held. And then to make the data points, in this case the circles, more striking, we can style them with CSS to make them red. And to add context, we added a title. I kept the title in here the whole time through the iteration, since it's usually a good practice to start with both a title and labels on your axes, so that even though the visual display of your data may not be the perfect ideal, you or reader still has a sense of what data you're looking at. And that concludes the dimple.js live coding example I wanted to go through, and hopefully you have a better sense of the process involved with reaching a final graphic.